You made it to the secret corner of the internet, where we show you 14 good old tricks that are really hard to find. We will cover everything from screen transitions to dropped inputs, useful plugins, and little tricks that make your life easier, gathered by the great people of our community or found by us working on our game First of Us Fungeon that you now can and should wishlist on Steam.
Number 1. By the power of the viewport texture. You can quite easily get a current screen into an image. Just get a viewport, get a texture, get a data, flip the image and create a texture from it. It sounds convoluted, but you can copy it and it is really, really powerful. Look what happens when we apply a simple dissolve shader to it. This is also how the typical flashbang effect is made. Just take a screen copy, make it brighter and fade it out. You can, of course, save this image and you have a screenshot. Or you make a digital photo album of the player's funniest deaths.
Number 2. The easy way to get file paths. Nizi and Fire540 brought us this one. When you want to load a scene from code, you do not have to type it out. Simply drag and drop it. You will get the exact path.
Number 3. How to scatter assets. When designing levels, there are things that need precise and thoughtful positioning. Well, and then there's grass. Scatter comes in super handy if things should be scattered or chained like a fence. It gives you a lot of flexibility. You should definitely consider this plugin when you map large 3D scenes.
Number 4. Rich text label effects. Some versions ago, text labels got super powerful. You can detect clicks to different parts of the text. And then there are all the crazy BB codes, like the wave, tornado, shake, fade, and of course, the rainbow! You can quite easily make custom effects too. This might be worth its own tutorial, but trust us. Rich text labels are insane.
Number 5. Serious serialization. Most games need a save and load feature. And with Godot, it is pretty easy to write variables into files if you use var to string to encode them. Just use it on a variable and then write the resulting string into a file. To load, just read the file and use string to var on the result. If you don't need the results to be human readable, maybe because you do not want to read save files or just cannot read, you can get more compact results with var to bytes and bytes to var. This can save you a lot of space for writing out large chunks of data.
Number 6. How to create empty shapes in 3D. Sometimes you need a rectangle in your life. There are several ways to create simple shapes in 3D, such as the CSG node. If you want a frame, you can use a CSG torus for that and set its sides to 4. Or to 3 if you want a triangle. Make the inner radius almost as big as the outer radius to get a thin frame and reduce the Y scale to make it flat. Thank you, CyberNav Games.
Number 7. Many control nodes eat mouse and key inputs by default. Just recently, we added a high score to our game and suddenly the combat seemed janky. Some inputs were simply dropped, no matter how hard we pressed. This was because we detected clicks with unhandled input, which is a good thing to do. However, this means that the input can be eaten by things like rich text labels and buttons. This simply can be changed with the mouse filter property. For text labels, the default is ignore, which is nice. It will let the input through and not inform the node. Rich text labels and buttons have the default stop, which will inform the node, but stop the input. This can create problems if you need the input in other nodes. There's also parse, which will inform the node, but also inform the other nodes above it, which is really helpful.
Number 8. How to disable the script template. When you open a new GDScript file, this nice little template is pre-written for you. But at some point you understood how the process function works and you do not need it anymore. Simply set the template to empty. Or set it to no comments and just get a ready function, which is kind of neat.
Number 9. 3D textures are compressed by default. If you ever noticed artifacts on your textures, check your import settings. Remember, the import tab is important. The 3D template imports textures as lossy with a quality of 0.7. For some images, this is barely noticeable, but sometimes you want it to look really clean. QBShay pointed this out on Twitter, where you should definitely follow her.
Number 10. You can animate colors, even of shaders. Animation players are your best friend. You can even use them to animate colors. You will get this cute preview. How nice! If you have a custom shader and mark a uniform as color, you can also interpolate it in that way. We just recently used this to make our background change colors.
Number 11. Use curves precisely. Curves are super powerful and convenient. Yada, yada, yada. They are so flexible, blah, blah, blah. Even my grandma uses them for her game, Trollator Racer 666. But have you ever tried to get this thing to make exactly what you want? It is fiddly to get an exact value. You can set the limits properties and hit it that way, or you can edit the file directly. Thanks, Affensinn, for the tip.
Number 12. There is a modulo for floats. To get a modulo of two floats, you cannot use the percent operator. You have to use the function fposmod. You can also wrap floats between a minimum and maximum value with wrap f. Just wanted to let you know.
Number 13. Talk to the operating system. Colin Weiser pointed out that you can easily check if you are playing in debug mode. This is an easy way to enable developer cheats or extra debugging tools. On a similar note, you can ask if the game is minimized by the user and react accordingly, for example by maximizing it.
Number 14. Vector 2 and Vector 3 have many convenience functions. There are just a surprising amount of situationally useful vector functions. You can calculate a slide of a vector given a normal, which is a cool feature on its own. Snap a vector to a grid with snap. You can interpolate between two vectors, linearly and cubic, if you feel like it. You even have a modulo for vectors, which I never thought I would end up using, but used it just recently.
This video is over. But you can watch other things we made. Here's our devlog, and here are 13 things you might not know. See you!